All right, I'm Pep Fernandez. This is Greg Bell. We are down at Rams training camp, Greg, and we're here at UC Irvine. The guys are about to come out. Everyone's excited about the Rams. Thousands of people are coming out to camp every week, including the stud alumni like yourself.
Oh, you know what? We're just one of the communities that are here to support the team coming back to town.
Now, judging by the fans that are flocking here to UC Irvine to see the Rams, there's a lot of anticipation. A lot of people just want to see these guys in helmets and pads and see what they're going to do this season.
Well, I'm trying to see as well because, you know, they don't really hit a lot in practice nowadays. My days playing here, never here at UCI. We were always up in Oxnard or over in Fullerton. But it was one of those things where we literally hit twice a day. I haven't seen one hit out here on practice.
Well, I asked you, I'm like, how's Todd Gurley doing? You're like, I don't know. He's really not getting a lot of work right now, which is opposite of what you did.
Man, do you know the first scrimmage was last weekend? No action whatsoever. And I understand that. You know, the guy came off a major ACL a year ago, and to come back and have the kind of season he had was amazing. But I'm just telling you, it's a blessing for these players now. They don't have to hit 2 days in a row. They don't even have to practice twice a day in the summer. And that's when we were getting in condition. You know, now they pay them to stay in condition year-round.
Yeah, and stay healthy, right?
Well,
you said you got injured in camp,
I got injured in practice. And that's where most injuries come from in my days because, you know, let's be honest, in a game, it's generally everybody's doing their assignment. So it's generally one or two guys that have a clear shot at tackling a running back. But nowadays, man, I mean, in practice, that's when it was live. And they don't do any goal line. They walk through goal line now. It's just a different formula for success now.
And that's the life, right? Stay healthy, just be ready for game day.
Stay healthy.
Is that it?
You know what? Stay healthy. Collect a check, but make a performance.
That's not a bad deal.
Hey, I'm just telling you, they got a beautiful setup here. It's not going to be a nicer training camp than you're going to see. The weather's perfect. Nice, moist heat. Everything is set for these guys to perform well. Now it's just about them going out and doing it.
Greg, as a former star running back, you spent some time with the Rams as well. You look at Todd Gurley. Is it pretty simple, despite who they're playing or what their system might be, you got to give him the ball, right? You got to let him run the rock.
Right. Yeah, and I tell you what, Todd took the time during the offseason. I think he told me he trimmed down 15 pounds. So you got a guy that's about 225, 6'1", 6'2", and he's got a lot of explosion. The knee is strong. He's strong. I talked to him out when they were up in Oxnard. He's excited to get started on the sophomore year. And really, the thing you're going to see out of him is not too much different. I think one of the things that everybody's told him is trying to keep both feet on the ground. He's one of those guys who enjoys jumping. And sometimes you're headed towards disaster when you get your feet off the ground.
Now, did you ever hurdle anybody in your day?
Everybody hurdles once in a while. I was a rookie when I was doing that too. By my third year, I learned. Definitely learned by my third year.
Well, Greg, the big question mark is who's handing the ball off to Todd Gurley, right? I mean, that's the huge question.
I don't think that's a question mark anymore. By getting rid of Nick Foles, they really hand the reins over to Goff. And Saturday at the scrimmage, Goff looked well. He connected well on a touchdown pass. He made good timing throws. The question is when he gets to game speed. Let's be honest. A scrimmage is what it is.
It is.
It's a scrimmage. And it's time when, you know, this Saturday night, when they go into the Coliseum to play the Dallas Cowboys, it's going to be a little heated because you remember last summer up in Oxnard, couldn't even finish the practice. They were fighting by the middle of the practice. So these two teams don't have a lot of love for each other. Hopefully we can go through a game without fighting.
So, Greg, we're talking preseason game, Rams-Cowboys at the Coliseum this Saturday night. How much value do you put in those preseason games? Do you really break that down and say, okay, this is our guy, or is it just repetitions and just getting some plays in there?
Well, you know, the preseason is not really about the starting units. I'm sure it's about looking at golf, but for the most part, they already know who their ones are. It's about finding the twos and the threes, utility players that are going to get you through the season. The most important thing for most of these guys right now is finding out where their special team players are, seeing who their utility guys are going to be in case Gurley gets a nick on it.
So the twos and the threes are winning
two
jobs.
Two and threes, they're winning their spot and they're winning that roster spot.
Okay, so week one, I think they open on the road at the 49ers on Monday Night Football. We know Case Keenum has some starting experience as a quarterback in the NFL. Do you go with Keenum, which might be the safe bet, or you sold the farm to get Goff?
You sold the farm. I think they've already sold the farm. It's almost kind of same scenario that the Raiders had 3 years ago when they got David Carr. They released the players that they had there. They cleared the way for him to learn on the move. And that's really what it's about right now. I mean, most rookies come into the league, and a lot of them are put out there to play. And unfortunately, quarterback is probably the most difficult position in the National Football League, but it's one that Goff is, you know, we know he's got the educational level to tackle that problem. Now it's about his worth of it.
Now, this is a team that finished 7-9 a year ago in a very tough NFC West. Is there a possibility, is there a scenario where you see the Rams in the hunt for a playoff spot? And I don't know if I say division title, because we got the Seahawks, we got the Cardinals, but do you see a scenario where this team is in the mix for that playoff spot?
Well, that's the beauty about the National Football League. This is work. This isn't about college. It's not about tutoring those young kids coming up. It's about going to work. This team is expected to win football games, and I'm looking at making a playoff.
I don't want to say pampering, but it's pretty nice here at UC Irvine. Going back to your training camp days, it was rough. Was it a good experience? Was it a rough experience? When you look back on it, it was like, it builds character? I mean, what was it?
We were playing football, man. That's the beauty of it. That's the love of it. When you come out here and you strap up that helmet, you don't care whether you're on dirt, mud, or concrete. The fact that you're getting a chance to do what you dreamed about doing your entire life, that's all that mattered to us back then. I wouldn't change the experience, but at the same time today, I would want this experience.
Now, you made a great point. You touched on the fact that a lot of the twos and the threes are trying to win, starting, or, you know, maybe knock off a number one, get a starting job, maybe just trying to get a spot on the team. Is that a dynamic we have to watch out here on the training camp field, like the twos and the threes, knowing they're going up against a starter and saying, you know what, I got to prove myself against this guy?
Well, I don't know if you're going to see yourself seeing a two knocking off of a number one, but you're going to see a lot of competition between three and two. They've probably got about 70 bodies out here. You can only carry 52, 53, and you can have about 4 to 5 practice squad guys. So you're going to see competition out of about 30 guys, because remember, there are a couple guys that are in the upper echelon of their career, year 8, year 9, they're trying to figure out if they want to keep those guys on the roster as well. So it's going to be competitive. You don't really see as much competitive unless they're full go practice. You know, of course, last week they were in shorts and shells that week. I think today might be the first day we actually see them with full equipment. So I'm not sure what the practice is prepared for today, but today might be the first day they actually got lowers and uppers on, and we might actually hear some clink.
That'd be
some
nice.
Click and clank.
Yeah, I want to hear some of that. Hey, let's, for a shout out to our Inland Empire folks, we've got Corey Harkey out here. He's a Riverside Riverside resident, I should say, right now. You know Corey, right?
Right, yeah. He's a Chino Hills kid.
Yeah, he is. Chino Hills High School. Where does he fit in? Because I've seen him lining up at fullback,
He is the H-back. He's our true position H-back. He's that guy who's a cross between a fullback and a tight end, who can block as well as catch the ball extremely well. Corey's mainly used as an H receiver. So you won't see him doing a lot of blocking, but you're going to see him getting the ball thrown his way. One of the things you have to appreciate about a young kid, the quicker you can get the ball into somebody else's hands, the more he'll be able to learn.
That's right. Corey's a big man, but he's got great hands, it sounds like, right? If he can be a receiver as
well. Yes, definitely.
Greg, is there anything else we missed? Is there anything else that people out there need to know about Rams training camp as we get them up to speed for that first preseason game and the first regular season game?
Well, don't come late, because the last day I was here on last Friday, 6,000, 7,000 people came, and the benches were full. So if you're coming out here to UCI, get here early, get your spot, enjoy.
It's free, right?
It's free. You got the Play 60 in the back. You got the music bumping. So if you want to dance your way here, dance your way here.
Is that what you did?
Come on out. No, I don't dance. I don't dance.
All right. For Greg Bell, I'm Pep Fernandez, and we'll see you next time from Rams training camp.
Take care.